Welcome back, everybody. Let's continue to talk about correlations. Remember, with correlations, we're trying to describe the relationship between two variables. One way we can get a sense of a relationship between two variables is by examining a scatter plot. This is a scatter plot right here. Using a scatter plot, we plot the data in two-dimensional space. If we have two variables, x and y, we'll have the two variables listed on our axes, the x and the y-axis. Just to give this example a little bit more meaning, let's consider the x variable quiz 1 scores, and let's consider the y variable quiz 2 scores. You can go ahead and write those in. And for every person now, we're going to have two pieces of data. So on quiz 1, this first person did pretty poorly, and the person did relatively poorly on quiz 2 as well. So you can see that person is plotted right here in the two-dimensional space. And then we can continue to plot each other person. So person B had a 1 on quiz 1, a 3 on quiz 2. That person would be right here. Person C, a 3 on quiz 1, a 2 on quiz 2. That person's right here. Person D, a 4 on quiz 1, a 5 on quiz 2. That person's right here. And do you see how there's a trend that's starting to emerge? Person E, a 6 on quiz 1, a 4 on quiz 2, and person F, 7 and 5. Now we see a very clear trend. What I'm trying to do throughout this is fit a straight line as best as I can to this data, because that's actually what correlation and regression is doing in the background. We're trying to fit a line to our data, a trend line to our data. And you can see where I keep passing the hand here through the data points. That's like our best fitting line right there. It's coming as close to as many data points as possible. And those data points are aligning with that best fitting line reasonably well, showing a somewhat strong trend right there. We're seeing that when people do relatively poorly on quiz 1, they tend to do relatively poorly on quiz 2. When people do relatively well on quiz 1, they tend to do relatively well on quiz 2. So that's a classic positive correlation that we're seeing there. So it's really nice because a scatterplot allows us to see the trends in our data, to see the relationship visibly. Sometimes when we plot our data, we see a relationship between the variables that's surprising. For example, look at this one down here. In this scatterplot, we're plotting on the x-axis the physicians available per 100,000 people in a population, and on the y-axis, we're plotting infant mortality. And just like above, we see that trend line indicating a positive correlation. So what it's showing is the more physicians there are available, the higher the infant mortality is. Now remember, correlation doesn't prove causation, so give some thought as to why that relationship might exist. It's interesting, and through correlations, we learn lots of interesting things. Let's take a look at a few more scatter plots just to get a sense of what a positive relationship looks like compared to a negative relationship. In this scatter plot here on the left side, we're looking at the relationship between the temperature outside and the amount of beer sold, assume like at a stadium or some other large place where events take place. And it would be helpful to understand that relationship if you're in the sales business, because you're going to get a sense of the temperature, you know, like in a day or so just by looking at a weather report. And from that, you then should be able to predict how much beer or how much coffee you're going to be selling so that you can be prepared. So here we see that classic positive relationship trend line starting at the lower left and then moving up to the upper right. And you can just pick out a few data points to interpret them to get a sense of that positive correlation. You can see these data points in here, they're associated with higher temperatures outside. And those same data points are also associated with larger sales of beer. These data points over here, they're associated with lower temperatures, so colder weather. And those same data points are associated with less sales, fewer sales of beer. And you can see that dotted line again, it's trying to come as close to as many data points as possible. It's what we call the best fitting line. It's actually the regression line. Look at how this trend is fundamentally different. This is what we would see with a negative correlation. This is, in this particular graph, a relationship between the temperature outside and the amount of coffee being sold. And here, when we look at like these data points right in here, we can see that they're associated with higher temperatures outside, hot weather. And those exact same data points are also associated with low sales of coffee. And that makes sense. When it's really hot outside, people don't want hot coffee. But when it's cold outside, see these data points in here, they're associated with cold weather. Those same data points are showing high sales of coffee. So when it's cold outside, people do want a lot of coffee. So again, if I know what the temperature is going to be coming up this weekend, I can predict my beer and my coffee sales. And that's the beauty of understanding the relationship between those variables. This is an important point right here. We are able to discern those trends that we just talked about, whether it's positive or negative, when we have a relatively strong relationship. If a relationship between two variables is really weak, sometimes it's hard to determine what the trend looks like. I'll show you an example of that in just a minute or two. Let's get some terminology out of the way. We need to make sure that we're all speaking the same language. We know that this is the x-axis in this graph, and this is the y-axis. And of course, that would be the same with this graph as well. This is always our x-axis, and this is our y-axis. We typically put our x variable on the x-axis and our y variable on the y-axis. So we have two variables, x and y. Now we call that x variable the predictor variable. And usually in your head, you can figure out what logically seems to be the predictor variable. It makes sense here that we're going to use the temperature to predict the amount of coffee sold. We're not going to be using the amount of coffee sold to try to predict what the temperature is. So usually it's pretty logical what the researcher is going to see as the predictor variable. Some people will call the predictor variable the independent variable, and I don't like that use of the word independent variable because I personally believe independent variable should only be used as a term in a true experiment. But one thing I am more comfortable with is calling it a quasi-independent variable. It's kind of like an independent variable. That makes sense to me. On the y-axis, we always plot our criterion variable. Our criterion variable, some people will call a dependent variable. And again, that term I like to use only in a true experiment. However, calling it a quasi-dependent variable, it's kind of like a dependent variable. That makes sense to me as well. So we're trying to use the predictor variable to predict the value of the criterion variable. So make sure you're familiar with those terms, predictor and criterion. X and Y. I mentioned before that when a relationship between two variables is relatively strong, like this relationship is right here, the data points will conform to that trend line, that regression line, pretty strongly. They'll conform reasonably well. Let's look at some variations of that in these four plots right over here. Let's not worry at this point what variable is actually X and what variable is actually Y. Let's just look at the data points. Here we can see a relatively strong correlation. And do you see how the trend is heading up this way? So it looks like we have a positive correlation. As values on the X variable increase, values on the Y variable increase as well. So that's a positive correlation. And if we were to fit a trend line the best we can through these data points, we'd see that those data points come pretty close to that line. If I were to convert this data into numbers and crunch the correlation coefficient, that would produce an R value of 0.90, which is really very strong. Remember, the strongest correlation we could have is a correlation coefficient of positive 1 or negative 1. Both of those are equally as strong. The positive sign for a positive correlation just reflects a positive relationship between the two variables. And if we had a negative relationship of negative 1, that negative sign just simply reflects a negative relationship between the two variables. So I'm just trying to help you understand a correlation of negative 1 and positive 1, they're both as strong as you can get. They're both the same in terms of their magnitude, their strength. It's just that one represents a positive correlation and one represents a negative correlation. This right here is a strong positive correlation. Do you see how it's a little bit harder in this case to fit a line to actually discern the trend? But the trend looks like it's heading down here. these data points don't conform to the line nearly as well. So here we have a negative relationship simply because of the trend, and because the data points don't conform as well, it's a much less strong, it's a weaker relationship. In this particular case, this would reflect a correlation coefficient of negative 0.40. Now look at this one. You see how these ducks are lining up perfectly. These data points rest perfectly on that trend line, that regression line. We can see it's heading down, so that's a negative correlation. This would be a perfect correlation, a correlation of negative 1. That's as strong as you can find. And do you notice in this particular scatter plot, we can't really see much of any trend at all. These data points look completely random. There's just simply no trend. That would show a correlation of 0. So if I know the value of the x variable, I'm not able to predict at all the value of the y variable. So it kind of looks like a shotgun blast. There's just no trend that we can see. So I hope that these graphs help you understand that by looking at the data, we can get a sense of how strong the relationship is, and we can get a sense of if it's a positive or a negative relationship. Scatter plots are really very helpful, and they're used quite frequently. People often create scatter plots early on in their analysis just to get a sense of their data, just to get an idea of the relationship between the two variables. In the next video, we'll talk about how we can actually compute these R values, the correlation coefficient, and we'll talk about how we can run that data through the 4 steps and figure out if the correlation coefficient is statistically significant. I'll see you in the next video.